sometimes when somebody comes as a teacher for the first time or with lesser experience, the same problem will be persisting, irrespective of whether it is technical or subject. Okay, so both the areas, or sometimes emotional aspect as well. So it is always better to group teachers. Whenever we want them to elevate themselves, group them with the team. Let them not work independently. Have 3-4 people. Maybe they're teaching the same subject or handling the situation, 3-4 teachers as a group. And what happens is that your strength will be learned by me. And never pinpoint the negative of the individual. You don't know this, you don't know. No, it is not. At one point of time, I don't know. At one point of time, something you don't know. Correct? But we have elevated ourselves by making effort. So effort is what is very important. And for the first time when you do it in a group, give a project, let them do it together. So you will add your strength, he will add his strength, I will add my strength. So the product will be very fine. Once you see the final product, which is coming out so fine with higher quality than the individual quality. Group quality is higher than the individual quality. So once we give this small project, when we introduce that, I may be knowing a little bit in IT, that's fine. But seeing you, how you are making it, I will pick it up. And then what happens is that when I do independently, that component will get added up. And somebody else will also have something else. So from some teachers, I will be getting subject inputs more. From some teachers, I'll be getting the technical aspect of it more. From some teachers, they may not be that great in IT as well as the subject, but how they talk, the body language, and how they deliver will be at a higher level. Okay, so allow them to make lessons together. And when they make together, present it to somebody else. So get the feedback. So what happens is that before you launch it, 3-4 exercises of this kind we have done. So therefore, everybody is confident. They have already trialed themselves. And with that trial, I know first time I don't fumble in front of the children. Okay. So all the fumble, all the negatives or all the hiccups gets over in 2-3 times. I rectify myself. And second thing is that whenever a class is happening, there is one more person with me who is also having the same lesson. If there is a hiccup from my side, the other person takes over. This is how we plan. So if there is a problem of connectivity in my house, I don't need to worry about, I don't need to get tense. Then 4 o'clock comes, then the session is started by the next person. So there is no problem. So I leave the control. So both the teachers were preparing for the lesson at the same time. They know the content. Okay. So in that way, the IT problems are also getting resolved. Okay. So my teachers are exposed to these kind of things as a team. And the peer learning played a very major role in this. And no other choice, they have to learn. Those who cannot learn cannot find a place. That's very important. That everybody should understand that. If I may not know today, but it cannot be forever. Okay, if you have to survive in the market, you have to learn. Not knowing at the present moment is not a problem, but not knowing for a longer time will be a problem. I need to understand that. So that effort has to be put in by the teachers. And it works. Once you make them understand, it works. That's how the level difference is reduced. I don't say maths, at least it's reduced. There are two aspects. One is first you train them virtually. I'm talking about the school staff. All the school staff. Well, first virtual training can be given with clipping of video that we are giving. How to come and this is the place with the school environment. So they are familiar with the school environment. So take small clipping of videos with the school environment and include it in your PPT and you can send it to them or you can have a live session also. Playing it. This is with regard to school stuff. And then you can call them to the school one day and make them experience the same order that we have given in the virtual exercise. Same physical training in line with the virtual session. Right. This is for the staff. But when it comes to the parents and students, it has to happen virtually. But in that, there will be a hiccup. That sometimes, because of whatever be the reason, all the students or all the parents may not be a part of it and we have no control over it. That's where the problem starts. if they are not attentive, they don't pay attention, and if they are not sincere about what we are doing, the problem starts, and that will be not the problem for that individual, but also for the rest of them, because they are going to interact. And that's where we need to stay. And we need to insist on the practices for the children on day one when they come to school. It might take time for us to correct them, but still we need to wait and do, rather than simply starting the classes or sessions at that specified time. You comply with the process, then you can enter the school, is what we need to enforce. One thing is that we can have committees and we execute, especially, but awareness about all the roles is a must for every teacher. Okay, so that is very, not only every teacher, every member of the school. Every member of the school, whether it is the gatekeeper or the sub staff or the clerk or the administration staff, everybody should know the process, because one is the hygiene part of it. Hygiene cannot be handled by one individual, because in classroom condition, the teacher alone is there with the children. So that is one. And in the restroom, nobody is going to be there. Okay, so in that case, everybody should be sensitized. One is the sensitization of the sub staff, non-teaching staff, teaching staff, administrative staff has to happen at the school level. Second thing is, the process has to be disseminated to even the parents and students before they enter. So there has to be an orientation. Look here, when you come to the school, at the gate, there will be a mat with hydrogen peroxide silver nitrate solution, which is about 1% concentration dilution. The school will be replenishing the solution thrice or four times during the working hours. So your feet get cleaned a little bit, and then you enter. They will take the temperature, and if the temperature is above 37.5 degrees centigrade, you will be asked to go to an isolation room. If you are with your parents, you can go home straight away. If you are not with your parents, then you stay there. We will communicate to the parents and they will take the necessary steps to reach you home. And have you brought the sanitizer with you? Do you have face mask or do you have glove? If all these conditions have to be checked at the entry point. So this has to be known to everybody, because whatever process that we define for children should also be the same for the teaching staff or any other staff of the school. So the process is not different. It is only the age is different, but the process and practices are the same. So when everybody is aware of the process that we set in, then I think that these committees may be responsible when we draft the process. But post that, I don't think that they need to be on the floor. Except for one reason, that they are clustered. They are appearing in cluster means they need to be separated. And so that part you need to have assuring people, and that's very important. And sensitization is must, and everybody should be sensitized in a synchronized manner, and there should be higher degree of polarization should happen on the policies and principles that we adopt. If we are able to reach to that level, and I don't think that anybody need to monitor everybody.